Hello everybody and welcome back to Goldcrest Valley. This is the final episode of this week, episode 40. So just 10 episodes to go until the end. Oh, it's very sad. But we're going to make the most of today because we have got a mod which we need to try out. This is a mod which has been heavily requested actually over the past few videos. This is called the Lely Juno 150. It's £12,000, so yeah, it's not cheap, but it's also not totally extravagant. This is going to make it much easier for us. Basically, this will clean the feed areas. It pushes up the feed all the time, so you don't really have to spend so much time on cleaning the animals out, which is obviously something which we have to do quite a bit of at the moment. So yeah, let's buy it. And I think actually we can fit this to pretty much any machine. You can fit a beacon to it for £120. That sounds quite fun. We'll put the beacon on and see what it does. I'm guessing it's going to flash. So you can put it on Manitou, but loads of people say I overuse it, so we won't put it on the Manitou today. We'll put it on a tractor, which can be designated to the cleaning farm. Actually, technically we should probably have three, but for starters, we'll just have one. Let me just see. I'll turn that off. Yes. We did get rid of one of the tractors I wanted. The case 1455. Which is a shame. We do have a few mods about. At least I did do. Oh, it's okay. Doesn't matter. We'll use this tractor. It's a bit big for the job. But it's all I have at the moment. First of all, we will try it out on the cows. The cows aren't terribly mucky, but I did notice there was a bit of feed spilt, so it will do something. I've never used this mod before, ever, so this is going to be totally new to me. However, I have read like a how-to sort of guide me on how to use it, so hopefully I'll be able to do this without messing up too much. I feel this is a bit of a daily occurrence going to the store. We go here nearly every single episode. So there it is. It's a strange looking thing, but I'm sure it'll work. Which is the front and which is the back? Yes, I don't know. Oops. £12,000 worth of equipment and I've just crashed into it. Because I haven't got a clue what I'm doing. I think it's the other side we have to attach to. It looks like it would make sense as that's where the beacon is. It's a very low profile beacon. Okay, so it's an interesting thing. I thought we could move it with the tractor, but clearly we can't do. So we're just going to have to drive it ourselves. That seems really weird. I'll go forwards first of all. Hilarious. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I saw a screenshot with it on a tractor for moving it about. So I really don't know why we can't move it. Unless it only fits to the back of the tractor. I'm not sure. It's a hilarious object. There's the beacon. Very fast flashing thing. That's got it. I don't know if that was the right thing to do, but it has worked. So it looks like you probably do have to... Yes, it looks like you do have to unfold that. It must put some kind of mount under there. So we'll turn it off. We shall transport it over to the cows, which isn't really too far away. We could put it on the back if we wanted to. The cows are just here. I don't know how mucky they actually are. The pigs are filthy. I think they are 0% cleanliness, so they definitely need this. Ideally, if we could afford to, we'd have one of these at every single yard, so three. But at the moment, that isn't really a very good option. I think it's quite expensive. Right, so we'll put that out of the way and we'll get back into it again. We'll close it up. I like having the beacon on, it's hilarious. So we'll start it up, and what we need to do is obviously get it going. So let me just reverse it over here. Oh, it's quite hard to steer. Right, so what I'm going to do is set it off on a worker, cleaning the area. Little robot. You see, it's one of these things which you probably wouldn't have unless you were quite a big farm. Technically, we don't need it because we've got only a few cows, but the amount of time we'd be spending cleaning this area up would be ridiculous without this. So just setting this thing going is a great alternative to bringing the Manitou over with the bucket and doing all that kind of stuff. Here it comes. Cleaning everything. Is it full? Could be full. Looks like it might be. Yes, it is indeed full. So we need to unload it. Now, the funny thing is, we can actually unload it into the pit next to us without putting it into the trough, but yeah, as I've never unloaded it before, can't say for sure how it's going to work. So I think the best thing to do is take it over here, just so we don't make a bigger mess in the feeding area. Right. Yes, I thought as much. I thought it might do that. So, oh, it's still switched on. Oh, stop it. Stop it. There. Good. And now it can continue to clean the area. So you can use it yourself if you want to, but I've just decided to use a worker. And yes, I should think actually you can unload it straight into this trough here. So we'll just get it finished up over here. We'll clean it all properly. And then the cleanliness should be at 100%. It's so funny, it's almost cute, if you can call it cute. There we go. So, we are done. We'll leave it here for next time. Should probably park it up somewhere. There we go. Oh, it's sad because we finished. But it did a pretty good job, has to be said. So there we go. The cleanliness is now 100%, looking really good for the cows. The pigs and the sheep, not so good. If we could get one for each area, it would be fantastic, but yes, they don't come cheap. So what we should really do is just transport the same one between each farm. But that would be quite a slow thing to do. I think really I'm happy with that. That is a nice little addition to the farm. So yeah, like I said, I've never used it before, so there might be some things I've done wrong there. I probably could have done some things better as well, but fact is, it's clean, so I must have done something right. Okay, so we're going to head back to the yard. The fence should still be planting those poplars. I didn't realise what a huge job it was going to be. Absolutely massive job. It'll be almost time to load it up with the next pallet of poplars. So yeah, we'll head back there and get it done. Well, it hasn't stopped yet. I just can't believe how much of this field it's doing on the first crate. That is the first crate still. It's almost as if it's buying them as it goes, but it isn't doing. It really isn't. So it's just a very efficient planter, it seems. But yeah, it can't be far off, because when I looked before, it was about 30-40%, I think. Yeah, I think it was. It is just 6% full. So any second, that is going to disappear, that crate, and we're going to have to load up the next one. Would you say that is more than 50% done? I had to start it from the other side because it got very confused and for some weird reason it wanted to plant back over where it had already been. So I had to start it at this end. But yeah, I would say that that is 50%. Possibly even more. So what we can do is stay very close, and as soon as it's empty, we'll be able to let it load up with the next one. Aha, there we go. Continue. Alright, turn the engine off. Good. So, as far as I'm aware, we don't need another crate, so that is that done. As for this field over here, well, I wanted it to be maize, really. So I think we're going to plant some maize in there. When we get the harvester, we'll get both the headers. So we'll be able to do everything. Issue is, yes, the maize requires a different seed drill, as far as I'm aware, so this isn't going to go too well. Unless that one there will work. Might do. Yeah, I don't think this one does the maize or the corn. Let me just see. No. As predicted. But this one here, this one is a bit different, I think. Although it probably won't do the corn either. Let's just see. No, it's exactly the same. Good. So, what we're going to have to do is get a different planter entirely. It is the same one which does the sugar beet, I think. So, yes, we'll just rent it, I suppose. Yeah, it is. It's different. Although, that isn't that expensive. That isn't very expensive at all. It does sunflowers, soybeans, is it? Is that soybeans? It looks just like beans. Same thing, I suppose. Corn and sugar beet. So, we'll in fact buy it. However, I wouldn't have thought that that is a direct drill. I would have thought we'd need to cultivate it first. So, yeah, best thing to do here is going to be to plant with the New Holland and cultivate with the case. Hopefully I've got that the right way around. We don't want to get it back to front. So where is my cultivator? Just here. The case is pretty much the only tractor which is capable of pulling this cultivator. Should get it done in no time at all. And we'll get the header moved as well, because that's likely going to be in the way. It could hit the shed at the top. It could do. It's not a very big field. Have to keep an eye on it. So, get this moved. I think, yeah, we'll just spin it around. Just as long as it's far away from the field, then it should be okay. And we'll take the pallet forks off as well, because, well, there's no need for them to be there. Whoa, that is a heavy trailer. I seem to put everything else here, so that can join it. And over to the store, again. This is our second time today. Oh, we love the store. I managed to turn around then. There is some intelligence in the workers after all. Ah, is that, which way is that going? Is that going back where it's already been? I retract my comment. There is no intelligence in these workers at all. So if you haven't seen yet, Chellington 17 is now out on ModHub, so you can actually access it in-game. If you go to the main menu of Farming Simulator, then click ModHub, you'll be able to get to it, or click on mods, you'll be able to get to the mod hub. And yeah, Chellington, the new map, or the modified map actually, from 15, definitely worth downloading. So if you like any kind of British maps, it should be right up your street. In fact, if you like any mod map, it should be right up your street. It's very good. Full of detail, quite a big map as well. So yeah, it should be pretty much for everybody. Unless you like really small, tight fields, then it might not be for you, but definitely worth a go. I just hope this tractor has got enough horsepower for this, because we're using all of our other tractors. Everything is in use. If the worst comes to the worst, we'll have to wait for the case to finish cultivating, and then we'll put this on the case. But it's a really small seeder, a planter, so it shouldn't struggle. I'm actually very impressed by the price of it. I was expecting this thing to be really expensive, even though £13,000 is still a lot of money. I would have expected it to be more, considering it is new. If it was used, then yes. Some of the prices in Farming Simulator 17 are reasonable, but a lot of them seem to be very expensive. Maybe it's just me. Now, it's currently set to sunflowers. Last thing I want to do is put it on a worker or whatever without changing the crop type. That'd be awful. However, I think we might be doing this ourselves using... Well, actually, do we have GPS? No, we don't have GPS. We can't use GPS. So I'm going to have to do it myself. It isn't a very big field anyway. Now, has that worker sorted itself out? Oh, it's not going... Is it going back up the same... Oh my goodness, what's up with it? It's not a good day for you, is it? Unless they're just blind. They could just be blind. Which would be a terrible thing. Oh, no, it's a missus now. Oh, no, that's me. That's me. Well, I know. Oh, yes. The reason why I'm a female character is because it was new. It is new to FS17. And obviously, this is the same series which I was doing at the beginning when it was first released. And, well, I'm not changing it halfway through. That would be kind of weird. Maybe this time you'll be able to work out which way to go. It is a different worker. We need to get this thing filled up with fertilizer and with seed. I'm not sure if we have fertilizer, but it isn't the end of the world if we don't have any, because we can spray it. We have liquid fertilizer. Or do we not have any seed? That'd be the next thing. Oh joy. So we don't have any seed at all. I do have a mod. It depends how expensive it is. It's just, it might not be enabled on here. It was a placeable seed refill point. Nope, don't think it is. Yes, the charging station. I should have installed that. Should definitely have installed it. 1 second, I have forgotten something. Okay, so here we are back at the cows, and I'm going to buy the charging station. So this is in placeables, and the charging station for Lely Juno covers maintenance costs for one Lely Juno 150. So, yeah, I don't think it does nothing. It's for looks, and I think in real life it would obviously do something. It would charge it, I'm guessing, hence the name. But yes, for us today, it is there to offset our maintenance, so it should make it cheaper to run, I'm guessing. So, yeah, we could just park it near it if we want to. Just like that, just there. They're the guides, so we can see where we're going. But I don't think we're going to need those. I did it mostly from looks today. So we'll turn it off again, and yeah, it looks quite good. It looks like it's charging, even though it obviously isn't. But yes, let's head back over to the main farm and get this field seeded. We need to get some seed. It would help. Now this case tractor here is finished. That was very quick. So we shall fold it up. Put it away. Yeah, so I would like to have the placeable seed, but I think for today we're not going to be able to. I think it's quite expensive. We'll stick with the pallets. or get just the one pallet. Now, I have tried this before with the pickup, with the IBC. That was too heavy, but I'm pretty sure you can do it with the pickup if it's just seed. So that is what I'm going to try. We're going to need a front loader. Well, the tractor we've got, actually, perfect. Unless actually, this is going to be the more sensible option. Everything is here which we need. I know I use it quite a bit, but it's just so handy. I mean, a real farm wouldn't replace a Manitou or telehandler every single day just to keep everybody happy. I know it is different for us because we're always trying to use the best and most different equipment, but we're going to have to live with it. I love Manitous, I think they're really good. I could never get bored with it, but some people do. Anyway, that Fendt tractor is getting there, slowly, but it's almost there. A very, very slow job. I'm going to buy 2 pallets of seed. We don't need an awful lot. I'm assuming they do take the same seed as the other seeder. I can't really see why it'd be too different. No, I think it would be okay. So 2 pallets on the back of here. These bales are once again going for a bit of a tour of the map. Oh, they love to go for a tour. We spend most of our time here. Hello again, Morgan's massive motors. So last time I wasn't too bad at this. Hopefully it goes just as well this time. I always hate it when I mess up. So we need to go into pallets, seed bag, big bag, 2 of those. Yeah, that should be everything. Should be all okay. Oh yes, it's these ones I hate. It's these ones I can't pick up. I don't know why. I think they fixed it. Just doesn't seem as hard to do anymore. I think what we'll do actually is put the straps on. Then I can see where they're going to go, so that's okay. And this one here. I think they fixed it in the previous patch. They've done a good job. I'm glad they do go to the effort of patching. Well, if they didn't, it would be pretty awful. But they're quite frequent, the patches, I suppose. That one can go there. Good. We'll now be able to do some seeding. Off we go. Back at the farm. Now, I wonder if we can actually refill the seeder directly from the trailer. It's not the most realistic thing to do, it's just it would be very quick. I would like to get on with this job. We'll have to see. If we can't do, then fair enough, we'll unload it properly. Well, we can do. That's good. Didn't really take too much either. We also need some fertilizer. Taking quite a bit more, and that's also made it much heavier as well. Right, so we'll just stop there, turn the engine of the Manitou off, and we will go and finally plant this field of maize. It's a good job we've got the front loader on, that's probably counterbalancing it quite a bit. We do have the markers as well. Yep, that is working well. And that's definitely maize that I'm putting in. Good. It's amazing how much harder it is without GPS. See the mark just about there. Keep it central with the bonnet and we should be okay. Thing is that it's moved. I didn't go perfectly straight, so it's made it harder. I'm going to continue off screen and I'll see you in a second when I have progressed further across the field. Hopefully it'll be looking quite neat, although I can't guarantee things. Right, so carry on okay. It's slow and not extremely fun, but yeah, I've got a picture to show you. Basically, somebody called Blaz emailed me and he sent me a series of photos of his bale stacking skills in FS15. Because when I was doing the Chellington video about a week ago, I stacked some bales and I said, how high can you make your stack? Anyway, Blaz got back to me about it. And here are some screenshots. This is one incredible stack. As you can see, it's a very impressive stack, very well done, and I should think it took absolutely hours to do. So thank you very much to Blaz for sending me that in. Love to see your different screenshots. Can anyone beat it? If you can beat this stack legitimately, without cheating in any way, please do also send me your screenshots and I'll try and get them into the next video. Now very shortly we're about to run out of seed, so we're going to have to go back to the farm. Luckily it isn't too far away to refill. The fertiliser doesn't go down very fast at all, but yeah, the seed really does. I think we should be able to get back down again though, go back down the field and then refill. Now I mentioned this nearer to the time, but as for the schedule for over Christmas, basically it'll be pretty much all the same except for Christmas Day itself. That is the only day, and possibly New Year's Day, when there won't be a video. But yeah, all the other days should be it should be business as usual, which is great. Always nice to produce these videos. I never find it a chore. I always love to make them. And one of the main reasons for my enjoyment of making them is actually to read everybody's comments. I love to see what everybody's got to say. Just 3% left in there. We'll see how far we can get. And then we're going to refill. Oh, I've got quite a long way actually. Almost to the bottom. Let's top up. It's not going to take a full thing, but we might as well because it fills up so quickly anyway. I'm guessing it's just not putting much seed in there. Hence the fast refill. That is super fast. Anyway, we're almost done, so I'll just finish off and that'll be us done for today. I think the fence is finished, so it's pretty much finished. That must be... Oh no, it has finished. It's just overlapping where it's been. So the poplars are planted. You just do this work here quickly while we sort out the fence. It's costing us money when it doesn't need to. Stop fence. So that means that if we left it, it would actually go all the way to the end of the field, replanting what it's already done. A little bit ridiculous. There's still 14% left in there. It did a very good job. Less than 2 crates. That's what we used. There we go. Brilliant. Good. So one field is done. Oh, what a mess. What a mess. It went right up the centre. And that's us pretty much finished. I've just done over there, cleaned things up, tidy things up, and yeah, things are getting back on track. The thing about these workers is they are useful, but they can annoy you sometimes. But without the workers, this game wouldn't really be the same. Very nice to have them. I mean, I wouldn't have wanted to sit there doing that poplar planting. That would have taken, well, it did, it took forever. Not literally, but you know, I think probably in real time it was about 2.5 hours. So yeah, that is a slow job. Very slow. Can you imagine, if you look at that, field 14, that's what we've just done. Can you imagine planting poplars in field 5? Whoa, that literally would take forever. That would be ridiculous. Now somebody's going to tell me in the comments that they've done it. Did you? Or did you get a worker to do it? I suppose there's no way of finding out for sure. But if anybody has planted poplars in field 5 and you've done it yourself without a worker, then, well, I think you deserve an award. Because that is dedication. Just tidy this bit up and then we are done for another day. Anyway, yes, just 10 episodes left, and that's including, yeah, that is including the Christmas special, because that would be classed as an episode. I won't call it that episode, but it will be one. I think we can park this in here. Very good store. It's a store which I never really use too often, and I should do. But yes, that is it for today. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. Yeah, the Juno, the cleaner, it is a nice thing. I just hope I used it right. I hope I did. It was the first time ever, so there is a chance I did it wrong, but it seemed to clean the place. But until next time, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again very soon. Bye for now.